sound system in all it is, Selector Hype live and direct. We are here in Luton. Sitting next to me right about now is three of the most popular, most talked about sound systems that we have seen in a long time. So many titles, so many wins under their belt. Their soul creativity is just on a par right now. Everybody's watching them. They are live and direct inside the UK. It's not a clash on the flyer. It's a juggling dance, but they're here live and direct to represent no other than Northern Lights.
Yes, man.
Thanks.
Blessings. I respect every single time. How's things?
Everything good, man. Everything good. Yeah. They are UK, so everything good.
Well, this is your, I mean, you've been to UK a few times now,
yes?
Yeah?
Yes.
How do you feel?
Actually, this is the second time, right?
Yes. This is the second time. And both, first time was a clash?
Yes.
Yes.
You're over here juggling this time. Is that a bit of a less pressure on you to just come over here and kind of like just...
Well, of course it is, because, you know, each time you have a sound clash, you have to prepare for it, and it really starts months before.
Yeah.
And then when you reach that day, of course you feel pressure. Mm-hmm. And yeah, tonight we're there to enjoy our... You know,
how are you finding the whole kind of new, because we could go right back in the beginning, but I know that, you know, sound checks out there, you're not going to get ready to perform.
No.
So we won't go all the way back to the history of the start of Northern Lights. So let's just talk about the present moment now. The one thing I see, you are constantly smiling, man. Like, you just, it's just teeth. Everybody's smiling around Northern Lights. So clearly, you're in a good space now in terms of sound system culture. What do you think has made you guys so popular right now?
I would say hard work, because right now we are kind of, you know, getting what we've been working a lot for. Like, I mean, after all these years we've been putting the work, right now it coming like the world start to discover Northern Lights, but we've been there like from 2 decades now. And so, if you ask me, there couldn't be a better moment for us to reach this level, because right now we're right.
Now you're in that position now, I believe that you are reigning champions for Euro Rumble. Is that right? So you're going to be defending it.
Yes.
Of course.
How much pressure do you think it is on you now? Because obviously, everybody knows, I won't say they know your bag or know your style, but they know that to get anywhere right now, you've got to really kind of go up against the best of Northern Lights right now. This is like leading.
Yeah.
How much pressure is it on you? How are you like making preparations?
Well, we're making preparation knowing that we'll be enemy number one.
Yeah, for sure.
And well, you can look at this from two points of view. I mean, there's a point where you need to keep up your levels, because there's a high expectation on how you will perform on that stage since you are the defending champion. And then you have this other point of view. I mean, we love Sound Clash, and I'm really looking forward to hear what they will bring us, what they will bring against us.
Okay.
Because I don't know what's wrong with some people, but nowadays this social media stuff is getting things away from the real vibe. And this whole rivalry they're creating online, if you ask me, is not as good as real rivalry, which is
taking place
in the dance. So I don't know, I'm really looking forward to see the Euromassive reaching out to U-Club in Wuppertal in Germany on the 23rd of June to you know, make it a great night of Sound Clash, because at the end of the day is Sound Clash. I don't know, I love this thing, but if the crowd is not involved in it, Sound Clash doesn't mean anything.
Okay, cool. I'm looking to catch a plane for that one.
Yeah.
It's the week before UK Rumble.
Yeah,
so I'm going to try and attend both of them. Okay. Michelle, I've got a question, which I have to ask you this question. It's a bit on a serious note as well, because when you check the levels, you are probably one of the only people that's in a serious predicament. One, you're female. Two, you're white.
Yeah.
Three, you're from Europe. Man, if the stress on you isn't even much more, you know what I mean? That's crazy. And you're still leading, you're still being able to, again, it's kind of
that's
like a pressure. Again, it's like a pressure thing. How do you
on it, please?
Oh, wow, yeah, that's really a good question. I don't know, I just feel like anybody else. I mean, I'm a woman, all right?
I'm from Europe, okay.
Yeah, I'm from Europe, okay. I'm white, I know, and that's it. I'm just here because I love this music, I love this culture so much.
Okay, cool.
So,
but what about the pressure?
Yeah, I feel the pressure from years now. Yeah.
Let me just get this. You two are together, is that right? Am I right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, so when you're home together, is there any one-on-one clashes going on, dub for dub? You know, how do you settle an argument? Like,
if he
doesn't do the washing up, is he like, yo, dub for dub? And then whoever wins has to do the washing up.
Even between that place.
Sure, man, bad man, I'll wash this.
It's amazing, man, that again, to be a couple and to be in this kind of tense environment.
But can I add something else? DJ Dezo is my brother.
Yeah.
Real
brother. Nobody
knows.
This is a family thing.
Yeah.
Wow, so I didn't actually realize that. So, okay then, so what's it like when, as a close-knit family then, and partners, when you lose a clash? How is it amongst you guys? How do you rally around each other if one's feeling a little bit down and, you know, you're gonna try and keep that upbeat moment? How do you do that?
I mean, we argue so much before the clashes.
But
after
we
clash,
a lot.
Yeah, definitely a lot.
Everyone has his own point of view, so we love to share, you know.
Yeah, but I think the most important thing is to do a good performance. Mm. So it's no matter if you win or lose a clash. I mean, after the clashes, of course.
A reasoning.
Amount. Not just one day.
No.
Okay, well, it's TV South System Select Time. Northern Lights are here. They're going to get ready. We're going to let them chill out and get ready. Last question. I'm going to keep it upbeat. I know we're going to link up again where we're going to have a proper sit down. We'll start from the beginning right up to the end. So I'm going to say thank you because they're representing South System Clothing and look out for them. I hope you represent my t-shirts for the world to see.
Yeah,
but the last question now, like I said, I'm going to keep it upbeat. There's no Northern Lights. Then imagine Northern Lights does not exist.
Okay.
Oh, wow.
You get a phone call from a sound manager who said, yo, why you can't play the song? Which sound, any sound in the world, if there's no Northern Lights, which is a sound that you would like to play?
This is really hard to figure out because we never come from this kind of school. I mean, in Europe, sounds belongs to who's playing the sound. So there's no kind of, you know, boss hiring selector and asking them, okay, go there, perform the dub side, just voice for you, go there and mash up the piece. Mm-hmm. So if you ask me, I don't know, maybe it's going down on our personal musical taste.
Yeah.
King Addis?
Yeah.
No, I don't know. I mean, I grew up on Jaro.
Oh, yeah, exactly. I don't know.
Yeah, it's really hard.
I don't
to
want
tell.
To ask.
I don't know. I think that the legacy of Jaro should be left alone. You should not touch it, while Addis has,
no,
you know,
to go this.
Yeah,
sure.
Kept going, and yeah, if Addis called me, I can say, if there's no Northern Lights, of course, well, I can think of that. Yeah,
Abishai and
Dezo?
I would think Addis, definitely.
Addis? Okay.
Yeah.
What about you?
I'm a Jaro fan,
So you go for Kilimanjaro.
Of course.
So that's 3-1, because I've always said King Addis. People, like I said, thank you for just taking the time out. Is there anybody that you want to big up social media? Like,
of I want to big up TV Sound System TV because, I've been following you.
Thank you.
I mean, it's like quite a time now, right?
Yeah,
a couple of years.
We've been doing it, man, so thank you.
So, big up each and everybody supporting it. And must big up all the Northern Lights fans worldwide because right now we are realizing there's a lot of people following the sound and we must say respect. Thanks indeed for believing in Northern Lights before we believed in our sound. That's the point. We never realized how far we can get until we saw people cheering for us.
Wow.
And that was kind of, wow, this is the impact, okay then.
Yeah, that was
our
So there you have it, Massive TV Sound System. Make sure you hit that subscribe button. Look out for the dance. Who will bust the dance? We're going to be covering that. Big up all the promoters and all the rest of the DJs. But we're going to try and get some of them in there as well and get another interview then popping up. But remember to subscribe. TV Sound System, Northern Lights. What more do you want? We're out.
Bless
one.
Up.
Bless up.
Big up, Juxy.
Yeah, the link promotion. Yeah. And everyone involved in who can bust the dance. Bless up.
Bless up.